So this spring, I started on a project that's a little bit bigger than anything I've taken on before. I decided to build a shed and a sauna. We call it the Shauna. And I also tried to film it best I could just with this GoPro. And so this is that video. Shortly after we bought our home, we discovered this cement slab buried in some brush. It's about 19 by 9 feet, and it's in pretty good shape. It's the perfect foundation and location for two things that we wanted: a garden shed and a sauna. The building itself would be 16 feet long and 7 feet wide, split in half with two doors to access. The framework went up in just a few days. I installed a metal roof and used some old metal panels for siding. Within a week, the garden shed portion was basically done, and it freed up a ton of space in the garage. Now for the sauna, it's basically just timber frames and metal sheeting at this point, so it's time to insulate. I use standard fiberglass insulation here between the studs, mostly because it's cheap and super easy to install. You just stuff it in. Next up is a layer of Reflectix. This stuff is crazy thin, airtight, and makes a huge difference in the insulation. I stapled it to the studs, taped all the seams, with the idea being that this will also serve as a vapor barrier to prevent the hot, humid air from escaping the sauna and potentially ruining the fiberglass insulation behind it. Now it's really starting to look like a spaceship in here. Don't forget the window. I installed a drop ceiling with a few rafters to create an attic, and then stapled the Reflectix to that. Now we have a nice air gap up here that we need to insulate. This is blow-in insulation that you normally would want to rent a machine to help blow the fluff around, but since this is a pretty small job, I just fluffed it up and threw it in between the rafters by hand. Not sure I would do it this way again, but in the end, it got the job done. How about some paint? Suddenly that old steel siding looks brand new. Now it's time to think about the floor. I plan to build an insulated floor with foam board and cedar planks, which means the stove will need to be about 2 to 3 inches higher. So I poured a small patch of cement where the stove will go. Now I can put down the treated 2x4s and the foam board to insulate the floor. The 2x4s are not attached to the cement. The cedar deck planks will just get screwed into the 2x4s, and the whole thing is held in just fine with gravity and friction. As much as I like that silver spaceship look, I do plan to side the interior with wood, and it's important to create an air gap between your vapor barrier and the siding. So that's what these fairing strips are for. I happen to have an amazing friend named Bob who collects salvaged material, and he hooked me up with this old chalkboard slate from a local elementary school. It's going to be a perfect heat barrier for the stove. But before I can install that, I had to think about ventilation, because yes, saunas do need airflow, especially if you're using a wood-burning stove. So I cut a 4-inch hole near the bottom of the stove. This will hopefully serve as an air inlet, bringing fresh cold air in, which then gets heated by the stove and either vents out the chimney or through the sauna window. I got some salvaged bricks from Bob, but I've never actually laid bricks before, so I hope there aren't any professional bricklayers watching this video. I worked my way through it, and now I appreciate brick buildings more than ever. It looks like the next generation is going to have more luck in this department. I ripped the top layer of bricks in half to make a home for the slate. A layer of black high-heat spray paint finished it off. I wanted a smaller than average door to minimize heat loss, so I ended up building it myself with 2x3s, foam board, and cedar planks. I didn't leave any room in the budget for a door handle, so this branch will have to do for now. I kinda love it. Now to side the interior. Wow, look at this pile of wood I bought from Bob. It's 1-inch thick, solid, full-grain cedar from the bleachers at Two Harbors High School. Amazing old cedar, but it's gonna take some work before it can actually be installed. I'm not sure how many hours I spent sanding, but it was certainly worth the effort, since I could have never afforded brand new cedar of this quality and thickness. Plus, it still has a little history carved into it. You can see these bench numbers and people's initials are carved in here. I tried my best to sand lightly over those spots. I think it's a really fun detail worth preserving. Now to turn these old benches back into benches. For a sauna, most of the heat rises, so it's important to have benches that'll get you up close to the ceiling. I borrowed some measurements from a kitchen chair to try to make it the right height for most people. It's really nice to have room for a two-bench setup. If you get too hot, you can just drop down a bench, and it should be 10 to 20 degrees cooler on the bottom bench. Look at this beauty! Morrison Stove Company. It's a small shop in Aitkin, Minnesota. They told me they make about 200 stoves a year out of their garage. It's a very simple stove, and certainly there's bigger, nicer, heavier stoves out there. Those prices can easily go over $3,000. Well, this one cost about $1,000 with a glass window, and it's gonna put out more than enough heat for a 7x7x7 foot sauna. Before installing it indoors, I fired it up outside to burn off any oils and paint residue. Yeah, this is definitely gonna be hot enough. Now I can finish up the cedar trim. What a great feeling to have that last cedar board installed. Now, I don't have a lot of experience with roofs and stovepipes, so rather than cut a hole straight up through the roof and risk leaks, I decided it'd be safer to go through the exterior wall and then up through the overhanging roof. The downside to this setup is it'll make your stovepipe a little bit harder to clean, so if you know what you're doing, maybe you go straight up through the roof, but I went this route. I used insulated stovepipe for the wall section, and holy smokes, that pipe is expensive, nearly $80 a foot. Luckily, that was the only segment that needed to be installed, and everything else is just your standard steel 6-inch pipe. I was told that the chimney should be at least 4 feet from the roof to prevent downdrafts and to minimize hot embers from starting fires. I went even a little bit higher than that, so I used 3 pieces of fencing wire to secure the pipe in strong winds. This next detail wasn't essential, but I've always been curious about using a 12-volt solar system. So I got this 60-watt panel kit from Top Solar, hooked it up to a lawnmower battery. In the sauna itself, I installed this little 12-volt reading light. Pretty cool. The great thing about big projects is you're always going to have spare parts. So I used some extra material to build a little woodshed along one of the walls. And now, it's time to steam. Feels amazing. The heat actually just comes from everywhere. It's just amazing.